retraced our steps and returned to the sanctuary of the morning chamber. The puzzles reset every day. I'm not sure at what time. My watch stopped during the first night as I slept. Though I have rewound it since, I have little idea of the actual time or even what day it is. What is it with this godforsaken place? We ended 3 days ago, and so far two of our party are dead, and there seems little hope of finding a way back out. The midsection of the tunnel we dug has collapsed, and though I have heard picks and shovels of our workers digging on the other side, it may be several days before they get through to us. In nearly every room there are traps, locks, and riddles. Some just turn on lights and open doors, but others appear to be designed to protect the tomb from intruders and can be life-threatening. In order to spare what remains of our party from further danger, I'm keeping this journal with the observations on all the puzzles as we encounter them.
You
this torch, which seems to glow from a crystal that has an unlimited power supply. I have navigated the tunnel, which looks as if it were dug out by the people who travelled with Henry Who, or maybe Henry himself. I have come across a lost maze. The air smells of death and decay without a trace of dust. Fortunately, I was also trained in the skills of cartography, and I set about sketching a map of the maze as I travelled through it. According to Henry's notes, he had done the same thing, but lost his map. Maybe I might be able to locate them and inscribe the details on mine. Whatever the case, I must press on.
Get out. Get out.
Thank you.
Reset the stellar clock, I was finally ready to enter the cryogenic sarcophagus. Above the humming sound of the huge cryogenic plant, I could hear gas seeping into my sarcophagus. There was no way out now. The door was locked tight. I was getting sleepy. If everything was done right, the next time I would open my eyes would be in the year 2062. Slowly, I drifted into the world of dreams.
What?